Did you know Worgen didn't always look like this? These evil, savage, humanoid-looking wolves with large fangs bearing out of their mouth and sharp claws in their hands? Back before Cataclysm came out, these creatures were so cool to me. For the most part, I just remember them being part of Shadowfen Keep, the instance. The Worgen stand about 6 feet tall and weigh generally around 250 pounds. They speak their own language, with barks, growls, and howls. Doing some more research, I found out the more savage of them are actually very evil creatures, and have an odd culture. They might look like they are just beasts, but they are actually pretty intelligent. The Worgen packs use a patriarchy, usually the oldest male leading the pack. Worgen were actually very honorable and would never challenge leadership. The patriarch would lead until he died, and then his younger kin devoured him. Yes, you heard me right, they devoured him. The Worgen actually see this as a sense of honor, as they believe that the flesh and blood of their own kind strengthens their abilities. I would have never thought them to be a playable race back in the day, what with these evil tendencies. See, back in the day, the people of Azeroth feared these beasts. They thought that they only recently appeared to ravage small towns and settlements out of some mad magical experimentation. Or they thought they came from the Twisting Nether, so hence they did not believe that they are native to Azeroth. I mean, look at them. In fact, they are native to Azeroth. The Worgen originate with the Night Elf Druids, specifically a sect of druids called the Druids of the Scythe. The sect of druids practiced a dangerous form. They call it the Pack Form. This form basically turned the user into a powerful, uncontrollable form that is similar to the form of the wolf Ancient Goldrin. You see, the pack form tended to degrade the mind until the user only had primitive instincts and killed anything that wasn't his or hers own kin. One name to identify with is Rallar Fangfire. He is a druid who had fought in the War of the Satyrs along with the Night Elves. Rallar had taught himself to stay sane while in the form, and eventually became the leader of the Druids of the Scythe by winning a fight with them. He also tried to convince Malfurion Stormage to use the pack form to help bring down the Satyrs. During the War of the Satyrs, Rallar's sect of druids started to kill their allies too while in the pack form. Not just the Satyrs. The Night Elves that were wounded by the beast could also contract a curse that made them turn Worgen as well. Like we see in the beginning of the Worgen starting area in the game. After he became leader of the pack, he had offered to teach them how to retain their consciousness while they were in the pack form. He then was known as Alpha Prime of the sect. Here's how the Worgen form we know now today came about. You see, Rallar wanted to seek other methods to help the druids to keep their sanity. They sought to submit to the energies of the Scythe of Alun, an artifact made by the Fang of Goldrin himself and the Staff of Alun. But instead of regaining their sanity, the energies transformed Rallar and the pack of druids to the Worgen form we now know today. What is worse, this form trapped them and enslaved them to their own primal instincts. This is where Malfurion Stormage saw that the Worgen were not a good thing at all, and banished the Worgen to a section of the Emerald Dream, where they would be in a peaceful slumber for all eternity. So, if they are banished, how do we see them in places like Shadowfen Keep? There's actually a really cool story on this subject. Who is a mage from Dalaran, researched the Worgen and found out that there was a way to summon them. He thought that they hailed from a treacherous world from which no corner was truly safe, and he was reluctant to summon them himself. I believe that this could refer to the Emerald Nightmare corrupting the place where Worgen roamed in the Emerald Dream, but that's my guess. This is where Archmage Arugul comes in. If you don't know about him, he was the boss at the end of Shadowfen Keep, and he was Gen Greymane's court archmage in Ganaeus at a time. But more about Gilneas in later episodes. Arugul was frustrated that Dalaran was destroyed by the Scourge and elected to use Ur's research to summon these Worgen to fight the undead. The Worgen did fight the undead, but soon after started killing the humans living in Silverpine Forest. Arugul had gained a lot of guilt from this and adopted the Worgen as his own children. Weird, I know. He took haven in the place we now know today as Shadowfen Keep. He then cursed the village people of Pyrewood to turn Worgen whenever the sun went down. At about the same time, a Night Elf Sentinel named Valin Starsen was sent to clear the Fellwood of Demons. She prayed to the deity Alun and was granted the Scythe of Alun. Yes, the very same artifact that the druids submitted to become Worgen. With the Scythe, she could also summon the Worgen from the Emerald Dream. So she did. She summoned a ton of them to fight at her side against the demons. Now this is where it all gets kind of confusing. It is said that Valind started to notice that, after sending Worgen squads to deal with certain parts of Fellwood, they never came back. And when she tried to look for clues to why, she never found one scrap of evidence. So, she told the remaining Worgen to stay put at Ashenvale to protect. She then set off to consult the only other person dealing with these kinds of forces, Arugul. She set off, but Lore states that she disappeared. This makes it very interesting, and I personally would want to know what happened to those Worgen. Well, that's all there is to know about the Worgen origin as of late. Tune in next time to see more lore about Gilneas and how the Worgen curse afflicted the people there. And if you like the show, subscribe to see more future episodes. Thanks for watching.
Why do we fight? To protect home and family. To preserve balance and bring harmony. For my kind, the true question is, what is worth fighting for?